So, hello friends, I hope I'm audible and visible. Please give me a quick thumbs up if my audio video is all fine, and let me check if everything is fine from my end. All of you, please give me a quick thumbs up if my audio video is fine. Chalo ji, very nice. So, welcome all my dear students in the first session of this month, that is the must know topics or the previous year MCQs in dermatology. I'm your NEET PG educator, Dr. Cheshta. And I'll be teaching you dermatology in this platform. You all are on the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG. Now we do give two type of subscriptions on the Unacademy platform. One is the free live classes, which are known as special class, and another are the paid classes, which are of two type, that is plus and iconic. Special class are free to access. You don't have to pay for it. While I do take a lot of special class every day at 11 p.m. 11 a.m. on the Unacademy platform. We also have two type of subscription. One is Plus, which give you an access to both Unacademy, and it has the access to all the top educators. You can access to the vast question bank. You can have a lot of opportunities like quizzes, tests, etc. And we will also give you a 1 year subscriptions. Okay, or we will also give you the printed notes on 1 year subscriptions and more. On Iconic, we have the combination of both Unacademy and PrepLadder, and in addition to the access to Unacademy and PrepLadder, it give you the opportunity of very sorry it give you the opportunity of the personal guidance from the top educators or from the toppers of the exam, test analysis, expert guidelines, study materials and study planners. Now we have updated our question bank with 25,000 plus questions. The batches which have started yesterday was the Focus FMG batch, NEET PG 21 Emergency Room batch, the Target Next batch, and the NEET PG 21 last 3 year PYQ batch. I request all of you to please enroll in any of these batch. We have a test coming up on 4th of September, 9 a.m. This is a NEET PG mock test where the questions are curated by all the top educators in their field. And I recommend or I request all my dear students to please be a part of this All India level grand test on 9 a.m. You just need to put a code to get yourself enrolled, and the code is CHESTA10. Highly recommend to just give this exam. For longer subscriptions, we have a 12 plus 2 offer, that if you buy a 12 month subscription, 2 month is free. And for 4 year subscriptions, we have a 60,000 rupees of Plus and 75,000 rupees of Iconic. This is the price list. I request all my dear students to please go ahead and get the Unacademy subscription. Now here today, I am targeting both those who are giving the exam next year, because it's a very high time to get yourself start up. And for those who are giving exam this time, I request you to just have a quick overview of the PYQ sessions which we are conducting on the Unacademy platform. So whatever you take, please use my referral code CHESTA10. And we also have a bug bounty program that if you have any inappropriate content, you can report and claim your prize. Starting with the first question, this is not the question which I want to ask first. So just a second. Yes. Which of the following does not causes urethritis? Please tell me the answer of this question. Today we are dealing with the PYQs. All the PYQs will be discussed. Those question which has been asked in the previous exam will start with the first 3 to 4 years, going to up till the 10 year previous year MCQs with respect to the dermatology topic. I request all of you to please quickly answer this question. Which of the following does not cause urethritis in male? Haemophilus Ducray, Neisseria gonorrhea, Trichomonas vaginalis, or Chlamydia trachomatis? Anyone? Very nice. The correct answer of this question is option number one, Haemophilus Ducray, which is the cause of ulcer. It's a cause of causes of genital ulcer, not a cause of urethritis. So please remember, very very important, it is a cause of genital ulcer. It is a cause of genital ulcer, not the cause of urethritis. So the answer becomes option number one. Moving to the next question. So I want all of you to please answer as quick as possible. Pseudohyphae were seen on microscopy. What is the likely diagnosis? And also one point is mentioned that a patient is HIV positive patient. Amazing, amazing. Monica, Ashwini, AD, remember the answer is candidiasis. Pseudohyphae are nothing but the budding yeast. The parent bud have not separated from the daughter bud, and the daughter bud again gives the daughter buds. That is the pseudohyphae appearance which is seen. And in HIV, you, because of generalized immunosuppression, you tend to see a lot of or an increased incidence of candidiasis compared to the normal individual. Coming to the next question. A 55-year-old farmer with black mole on the cheek, increased in size, becomes irregular, invade the deep tissue. What could be the diagnosis? Acral lentigo, lentigo maligna, superficial spreading, or nodular melanoma? What is the correct answer? Very nice. The correct answer is option number 4. Now, what happens in melanoma? You have 4 types. In one, you have horizontal spread, and one you have deeper vertical spread. Now, horizontal spread, the examples are acral, lentigo maligna, and superficial type, while deeper invasion is the example of nodular type of melanoma. So only Ashwini is right. Pavneet, Monica, AD, please remember, the correct answer is option number 4. Please tell me the answer of this question. A patient presents with blue-purple asymptomatic lesion on the face on sun-exposed areas. Now, here comes a little confusion. First of all, when do you see bluish-purple pigment? You see bluish-purple pigment when you see bluish-purple pigment in those cases. You see bluish-purple pigment in those cases where you have the pigment present in the dermis. You have pigment present in the dermis. So whenever you have pigment present in the dermis, you have blue color, and that is because of the Tyndall effect. Now, in only one condition, the pigment falls down, and that is lichen planus. What happens in lichen planus? You have formation of Max Joseph space, which are the empty spaces which occurs at the site of previous colloid bodies or cited bodies. Now, through these empty spaces, the melanin falls down in the dermis. It is taken up by the macrophages, which are then called as melanophages, and they will give a bluish purple appearance on the sun exposed areas, and this is given a term, lichen planopigmentosis. It is asymptomatic, specifically seen on the sun exposed areas. Clear, all of you? Let's move to the next question. Please tell me the next question. A patient has onychomycosis, he should be prescribed a nail lacquer containing. Amazing, all of you, amazing. So nail lacquer is a thick formulation similar to a nail paint, and the drug which you give is amorphine. Other than amorphine, we have cyclopyrox. Both these drugs comes in a formulation which is known as nail lacquer formulation. Now you have to ask the patient to file the nail and apply these formulation on the nail plate, and with time they get absorbed and they cause destruction to the dermatophyte which is present on the nail plate. So everybody is right, the correct answer is option number 4. Coming to the next question. Year-old boy with intense itching since 1 week. On examination, there is a large circular lesion on the back. What is the likely diagnosis? Again, it's a repeat question, very easy. I have told you annular lesion with central clearing associated with intense itching. This is a case of tinea corporis. So you all are right. The correct answer is option number 1. That is tinea corporis. Corporis means present over the body. Okay. Coming to the next one, a child with scaly dry skin since birth, he had colloidal membrane at birth, what is the diagnosis? What is the correct answer? The child with scaly dry skin since birth has colloidal membrane at birth. What is your diagnosis? Very nice. Now, colloidal membrane is present in lamellar rictiosis. And what is the defect in a patient of lamellar rictiosis? Transglutaminase. So, this was a recent repeat question that ichthyosis and a history of colloidal membrane, always think about lamellar ichthyosis where you have TG enzyme transglutaminase deficiency. Coming to the next one, again a repeat, this was a repeat in AIMS last I think 2 or 3 years back, and a very similar question was asked to you in NEET as well. Anyone? Patient comes with a lesion on the shoulder and the chest, central scarring with presence of or the increase in the size in the periphery. Anyone? Very nice, Ashwini. Very nice, Monica. Can you tell me the name of the diagnosis here? What is the diagnosis? You are right. The patient will be given anti-TB treatment, but can you tell me what type of cutaneous tuberculosis is this? What type of cutaneous tuberculosis is this? Can anybody tell me the answer? Very nice. This is a classical case of lupus vulgaris, where you have inactive center or atrophic center and activities present in the periphery. इट कीप ऑन प्रोग्रेसिंग थ्रू दी पेरीफेरी, इट कीप ऑन मूविंग थ्रू दी पेरीफेरी. ठीक है, सो यू हैव टू गिव एंटी टीबी ट्रीटमेंट. कैन एनीबडी टेल मी फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज और मंथ यू हैव टू गिव अ एंटी टीबी ट्रीटमेंट इन क्यूटेनियस ट्यूबरक्लोसिस? कैन यू टेल मी द आंसर? ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ क्यूटेनियस ट्यूबरक्लोसिस इज वॉट? हाउ मेनी ड्रग्स एंड फॉर हाउ मेनी डेज? सुजीत, मोनिका, एनीवन, अश्विनी, श्रीदेवी, सुशांत, प्लीज रिमेंबर क्यूटेनियस टीबी द ट्रीटमेंट इज सेम. 6 month of anti-TB medicines with 2 month of intensive phase and 4 month of continuation phase. 2 month of intensive phase and 4 month of continuation phase. In 2 month of intensive phase, we give HRZE, rifampicin, isoniazid, pyrazinamide and ethambutol. And 4 hours of continuation phase, we give rifampicin, isoniazid and ethambutol. ठीक है, सो दैट रिमेन्स द प्रोटोकॉल विच इज वेरी सिमिलर टू दैट ऑफ पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरक्लोसिस. कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, a female presents with multiple warty lesions around the vulva. The lesions are gradually increasing and on examination they are soft, sessile, did not bleed on touch. What is the likely diagnosis? Very nice, Sujit, Smiley, Astha, Asha, AD, Ashwini. Very nice, all of you. Now, multiple warty. Whenever you get this term warty, always keep one DD in your mind, and that is HPV infection. And if it is present on the genitalia, condyloma acuminata becomes the first option of choice. And what is condyloma acuminata? It is nothing but another name for genital wart. Can anybody tell me which strain of HPV causes genital wart? Which strain of HPV causes genital wart? Anyone can tell me the answer? Asha, Ashwini, AD, Madhu, Sushant, Harpreet, Monica. What is the strain of HPV causing? The strain of HPV causing the genital wart is HPV 6 and 11. Okay? HPV 6 and 11. Very nice, Monica. Now here you have more than one options, right? And let me see if you can answer this. Or I can make it 4 options for you. Just wait, I am making the 4 options. Option number 1 is 1, 2, 3. Option number 2 is 2, 3, 4. Option number 3 is 2, 3, 5. And option number 5 is 3, 4, 5. Please tell me the correct answer of this condition. You have to choose among these 4 options. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't have to choose among this. So Ashwini have given me one answer. What about the other students? Okay, Monica and Ashwini are for option number 2. While Astha is for option number 4. Anyone else? Please remember the correct answer is option number 2. So everybody is right. Gamma is a feature of tertiary syphilis. While canker is a feature of primary syphilis. So the correct answer becomes 2, 3, 4 which is present in the secondary syphilis. Clear? Sujit, please give me a thumbs up if you understood. Sujit, आशा ऑल ऑफ यू दोज हैव नॉट मार्क द करेक्ट ऑप्शन प्लीज गिव मी अ थम्स अप इफ यू अंडरस्टूड. कैंकर इज सीन इन प्राइमरी सिफिलिस, इट्स अ फीचर ऑफ प्राइमरी सिफिलिस. नाउ अगेन आई एम मेकिंग द ऑप्शन नंबर 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now regarding the difference between atopic dermatitis and seborrheic dermatitis, you have to tell which of the following feature is specific to atopic dermatitis. Your options are given on the right side. Regarding the difference between atopic dermatitis and seborrheic dermatitis, atopic dermatitis has very nice. All my dear students, the correct answer is option number 3. Atopic dermatitis is more red and more pruritic, while seborrheic dermatitis is more greasy because of melasthesia and has scalp improvement. So Madhu, the correct answer is option number 3, that is number 2 and 4. Rest all features are with seborrheic dermatitis. Here also actually you have more than one options, right? Can you tell me what is the correct answer? All about or about granuloma annulare, all are true except. About granuloma annulare, all are true except. More common in diabetes, typically seen in homosexuals, treated with steroids, dorsal surface of hand and feet, and usually ulcerative. Now please remember, the correct answer is option number 5. But if they ask you more than one option, then please remember, it is not only seen in homosexuals. Granuloma annulare is a necrobiotic disorder. So necrobiosis occurs in any condition which causes damage to collagen. So what are the conditions which causes damage to the collagen? The conditions like increased blood sugar level. The blood sugar increase can cause damage to the collagen, giving rise to these granulomas. The next is, even the elderly age, the sun-induced damage in the age can lead to the necrobiotic disorders where you have collagen granulomas, and that is why you could have the granuloma annulare in other conditions of or other than homosexuals, like in diabetic patients and in elderly patients, those who have a frequent history of sun exposure. Clear all of you? Coming to the next question. Which of the following is incorrect? Which of the following statement is incorrect about pemphigus seen in elderly? There are flaccid blisters, autoantibody against the hemidesmosome, and there may be pruritus. Which of the following statement is incorrect? वेरी नाइस, द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर टू. यू डू नॉट हैव फ्लैसिड बुले, यू हैव टेंस बुले. फ्लैसिड बुले इज द करेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ वॉट? यस, फ्लैसिड बुले इज द करेक्टरिस्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इंट्राएपिडर्मल एकेंथोलाइटिक डिसऑर्डर्स. बट पेम्फिगोइस इज अ सब एपिडर्मल वेसाइक्युलो बुलस डिसऑर्डर एंड दैट इज वाई यू टेन टू सी टेंस बुला. इट इज सीन इन एल्डरली, दिस इज ट्रू. एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट द हेमिडेस्मोसोम, दैट इज बी पी एंटीजन 1, एंड इट मे बी एसोसिएटेड विद प्रूराइटिस बिकॉज ऑफ एक्टिवेशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लीमेंट. All these statements are correct except option number 2, that is they are flaccid blisters. Okay, other than this all the options are correct. Pseudo isomorphic phenomena is seen in Pseudo isomorphic phenomena is seen in anyone? Very nice, the correct answer. Whenever they say pseudo isomorphic, it becomes the infective conditions like viral wart, molluscum contagiosum. What happens in infective condition? You have something called as autoinoculation. You have something called as autoinoculation, so that site get inoculated, self-inoculated by the infective condition, giving rise to following feature. So pseudo isomorphic phenomena is seen in the patients of wart or molluscum contagiosa. So with this we are done with the today's session. We do have one more session in the evening. I request all my dear students to please be live in the evening session also. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel. The name is Let's Crack Neat PG. The name is Let's Crack Neat PG. You can also follow me on the Telegram group. The name is Let's Crack Neat PG. Subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code CHESTA10. And please hit the bell icon to get the notification of all.